In this video, we'll evaluate several inverse trig expressions expressing our answer in radians. So for the first expression, we have inverse sine of negative square root 3 over 2. So we're looking for an angle that has a sine function value of negative square root 3 over 2. So one of the most important things about evaluating these expressions is knowing the interval for the output or the range. Inverse sine or arc sine will only return an angle in the closed interval from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. So the first thing we need to be aware of in all of these expressions is, what is the interval for the possible outputs? For inverse secant or arc secant, the output is an angle theta in the same interval as inverse cosine or arc cosine. So we have the closed interval from 0 to pi, except theta cannot equal pi over 2, since the secant function is undefined at pi over 2. For arc cosecant, the output or range for arc cosecant would be the same as the output for inverse sine or arc sine, meaning on the closed interval from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2, except theta can't equal 0 radians because the secant function is undefined at 0 radians. And for inverse cotangent or arc cotangent, this expression will return an angle theta in the open interval from 0 to pi radians. Now, some textbooks do use the interval from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2, but this interval, I think, is a little bit more common. Now let's go ahead and complete our reference triangles. Here we have the 30-60-90 triangle. So we could label the short leg 1, the hypotenuse 2, and the longer leg square root 3. And for the 45-45-90, we would have 1-1 square root 2. So let's go ahead and evaluate these. For inverse sine negative square root 3 over 2, we're looking for an angle that has a sine function value of negative square root 3 over 2 in this interval. So let's take a look at our reference triangles first. Notice that the sine of 60 degrees is square root 3 over 2, which means 60 degrees is our reference triangle. But since we need a negative sine function value, we're going to have a 60 degree reference angle in the fourth quadrant. So our reference triangle would look something like this, where the y coordinate would be negative square root 3. So the sine of this angle here, our reference angle, is negative square root 3 over 2. Therefore, this would be a negative 60 degree angle, or negative pi over 3 radians. For the next example, we're looking for an angle that has a secant function value of 2, or if we want, we could write this as 2 over 1. And the reason that's helpful is, if the secant function value is 2 over 1, then inverse cosine would be 1 over 2, the reciprocal. So it'll be a little bit easier for us to recognize the angle if we use inverse cosine rather than inverse secant. Again, going back to our reference triangles, a 60 degree angle does have a cosine function value of 1 half. So our reference angle is 60 degrees, and since the cosine function value is positive, it'll be in the first quadrant. Therefore, our angle in this interval is going to be 60 degrees, or positive pi over 3 radians. Inverse cosecant 2 square root 3 divided by 3 means you want to find an angle that has a cosecant function value of this ratio, which is going to be a little bit challenging, but if inverse cosecant is equal to this ratio, then inverse sine would be equal to the reciprocal ratio, or 3 divided by 2 square root 3. So if we take a moment and rationalize this and simplify it, it'll help us recognize our reference angle. So let's go ahead and do that up here. We have 3 divided by 2 square root 3. We're going to rationalize this. So we're going to have 3 square root 3 all over. This will be 2 times 3, which is 6. So this simplifies to square root 3 over 2. So this is inverse sine of square root 3 over 2. Again, going back to our reference triangles, notice that 60 degrees has a sine function value of positive square root 3 over 2. 60 degrees is a reference angle, and we also want, and it's also in the first quadrant. So the angle we're looking for is 60 degrees, or positive pi over 3 radians. And for the last example, we have inverse cotangent negative 1. So we want an angle that has a cotangent function value of negative 1. Well, a 45 degree angle does have a cotangent function value of positive 1, so 45 degrees will be our reference angle, but since we want an angle in this interval, it's going to have to be in the second quadrant. So we'll sketch a 45 degree reference angle in the second quadrant. That would be here. Notice how the x coordinate would be negative, the y coordinate would be positive, and this would be square root 2. So the angle we're looking for on this interval would be from here to here, or 135 degrees. And 135 degrees is the same as 3 pi over 4 radians. And just be aware on this last one, if your textbook defines the output or the range for inverse cotangent as theta on the interval from negative pi over 2 to positive pi over 2, then instead of 3 pi over 4, we'd be over here in the fourth quadrant at negative pi over 4. So be sure and check your textbook on their definition of the output or range for inverse cotangent. I hope you found this helpful.